Good morning to St. Matthew's and to Calix St. Lawrence. It's great to be back with you for our weekly worship. Welcome to you, whether you are in school at the moment or whether you are joining in from home. As you can see, I'm joining from home this week. I'm not in the church, and that's because as a family, we are having to isolate at the moment, which feels very strange. So I know what it's like for lots of you being at home, but we can still be together like this. So that's great. Now, if you remember last week, we started to think about some of the stories in Jesus's gospel of when Jesus did miracles. Now, if you've got a good memory, I wonder if you can remember which story we thought about last week. Tell the people you are with if you can remember. It was the story of when Jesus turned water into wine. Well, this week, we're going to be thinking about another of those amazing miracles. And in a little while, Reverend June is going to help join us, help us think about that. And this week, it's going to be another amazing story that shows us just how incredible Jesus is. But it also can show us how even the small things we can offer to God can make a huge difference. Okay, well, we're going to begin our worship, as usual, by lighting a candle. Now, I can't light the enormous candle in church, but I have got a fairly big candle behind me. So if you've got a candle where you are, either in your class or at home, and it's safe to light it, then why don't you light your candle, as I light mine, to show that we're starting to offer our worship to God, and then we will say our opening prayer. Okay, so our opening prayer is going to appear on the screen now. So do you remember we did this prayer last week? So a reminder, I say God is good, and then you reply all the time. Then I say all the time, and then you say God is good, to remind us that God is good to us all the time. You ready? God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. Okay, fantastic. So now we're going to sing our first song, which is Bigger Than Big. Now, if you're at home, you can join in and you can sing as loudly as you like, as long as that's safe. If you're in school, then you're going to join in by signing. So let's enjoy Bigger Than Big. And then after that, we'll pass to Reverend June for today's story.
God, you made our big blue sky. You made the oceans deep and wide. God, you made the trees so tall. And your love is bigger than it all. God, you're bigger than big. You're stronger than strong. You are mightier than mighty. And louder than this song. Just farther than far, I can imagine just how big you are, just how big you are. God, you made our big blue sky. You made the oceans deep and wide. God, you made the trees so tall. And your love is bigger than it all. God, you're bigger than big. You're stronger than strong. You are mightier than mighty. And louder than this song. And your love for me stretches farther than far. I can't imagine just how big. God, you're bigger than big.
good to be with you again. And it's great to see you too, Em. What are you looking at? Oh, you've seen my chocolates. Can you have one? Oh, Em, you'll get them all the way down your t-shirt and all over your face. And anyway, they're my chocolates. And I was going to keep them all for myself, enjoying them this evening and tomorrow and the next time. You think that's really rotten? Keeping all the chocolates for myself? And not even being willing to share one of them, as there are so many in there? Oh, Em, you're absolutely right. And I'm so sorry that I was so selfish and not willing to share them. But I tell you what, we were going to watch Frozen 2 tonight, weren't we? And why don't we save the chocolates till then and share them together? How does that sound, my friend? Okay, are we friends again then? Can I have a big hug? Bye! Well, I wonder how willing we are to share what we have and to be generous to one another. You know, it can be so easy to be a bit like I was just then with the chocolates, holding everything that we've got for ourselves. But you know, it can make a real difference if instead of doing that, we're willing to share what we have with other people and be generous towards them in whatever way we can. And this week, we're thinking about a young lad called Joe, who made an amazing difference by being willing to share the food that he had. I wonder whether you can remember how much food there was in his lunchbox. 5 loaves and 2 small fish. And he was in a huge crowd with Jesus. And partway through the day, he began to realise that everybody round about him was getting so hungry. But instead of keeping his food to himself, he decided he wanted to do what he could to make a difference to everybody else. So he took his lunchbox and he gave it to Andrew, a friend of Jesus's, one of his disciples. And Andrew took it to Jesus. When they looked inside, they found there wasn't very much food. But Jesus smiled and he said, "Thank you to God for the food." And then he gave it to the disciples to start giving out. And I wonder whether you can remember how many people there were in the crowd. 5,000 men, let alone women and children, and all of them had more than enough to eat. And there were even 12 baskets of scraps that were collected. And Joe, by being willing to share what he had, what little he had, with all those people, was able, with the help of Jesus, to make an amazing difference. And I want to encourage us today to be thinking about how we too may be able to make a difference with God's help by being willing to share the things that we have. And I want to finish by telling you about 2 people who shared in very different ways. First of all, there was a man called Martin. He was a bishop. And one day he was riding along on his horse when he saw a beggar, and the beggar was freezing cold. So Bishop Martin got out of his sack a cloak that he was carrying. And he split the cloak in two. And he took part of the cloak and he gave it to the beggar to wrap round himself so that he could keep warm. And Bishop Martin kept the other half of the cloak for himself. And that night he dreamt about the bit of the cloak that he gave to the beggar. But instead of it being wrapped around the beggar, it was wrapped around Jesus. And Bishop Martin realized that not only had he managed to make a real difference to the beggar, but he'd also delighted the heart of Jesus by being willing to share the cloak that he had. That was one person, but the other one was a lady called Ruth Saunders. I wonder whether you can guess from this picture how old she was. She was 104 years old last year. And when the coronavirus struck, she decided she wanted to do something to help by giving her time and energy to do a marathon to raise money for the Thames Air Ambulance, which flies people who are really poorly to hospital so that they can get the help that they need. And Ruth set out on September the 8th and she walked around the block near her home. And then she did it the next day and the next day. And she did it every day, come rain or shine, no matter how tired she felt. She shared her time and she shared her energy until November the 4th, when she finished her 26 miles and she raised a huge amount of money for the air ambulance. And she was even given a special honour by the Queen at New Year, an MBE. And today, I want to encourage us to remember Joe sharing his lunchbox and to remember Bishop Martin sharing his cloak and Ruth sharing her time and energy, all of whom, with the help of God, were able to make a real difference to people as a result. And I want to encourage us to be thinking about how we might be able to share and be generous with what we have and with God's help to make a difference to someone even this week.
So isn't that an extraordinary story that we hear in John's Gospel of something that really happened, that was a miracle, when that little boy gave to Jesus his packed lunch and Jesus, with that little gift, all that that boy had, did an amazing thing with it and fed that huge crowd. And thank you too to Reverend June for telling us about those other stories. That man Martin giving the cloak or half his cloak to that poor man. And actually he went on to become Saint Martin. If you hear churches called Saint Martin's, they're named after him. And also that wonderful story about that old lady, 104 years old. All she could do was do walking around, but that raised masses of money for the air ambulance to help lots and lots of people. So, and all of us can think, what little thing can I offer that with God's help gets turned into something amazing? So with that in mind, we're going to say a prayer now, which is going to appear on the screen. So let's say this prayer together, or perhaps if you're in class, then maybe your teacher would like to ask one of you to read the prayer with me on behalf of the whole class. Okay, here we go. Lord, thank you that you did an amazing thing when you fed 5,000 people with 5 loaves and 2 fish. Thank you for the small boy who was prepared to offer to you the only thing he had. Help us to be prepared to offer to you the small things that we can do and to trust you that you will do amazing things with them. Amen. So we're going to sing now our second song, which is another song praising God for how amazing he is. So this is How Great Is Our God. And once again, if you're at home, feel free to join in and sing. If you're in school, then please join in with the signing. Hope you enjoyed that song. So let's turn to our time of prayer, and we're going to begin by saying together the Lord's Prayer. We're going to do the actions. If you're not quite sure the actions, try and follow me, and we'll gradually learn the actions. Okay, so we start like that, which is a symbol for Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And now we're going to have the school prayer on the screen. Are you ready? Dear Heavenly Father, up above, look down on our school with love. Shower us with happiness, shield us from sadness, together forever. Amen. And then it's a final prayer, which is asking God to bless us through everything that we're going through at the moment. Lord, you walk with us in darkness and keep us safe. We lift our hearts to bless you. Lord, you teach us and show us the way. We lift our hands to bless you. Lord, you love us and shine your light on us. We lift our lives to bless you. So thanks everyone once again for being part of this week's worship. It wasn't that an amazing story. We heard another of Jesus's miracles, and we're going to be thinking about another of his miracles next week. Thank you to Reverend June and to Em, of course, for joining us today. So let's remember, we might think, well, I've only got something very small I can offer, but with God's help, the things that we offer can do amazing things to help other people and to make a difference in the world. So let's try and do that this week. May God bless you and be with you. And I'll see you this time next week. See you then.